we're sitting in the White House map room, which is where they planned World War I. And so they have all these maps with like yarn and pushpins where the routes where all the the troops were, you know?
Holy cow.
And we're just sitting there and Zach like sits down on a chair and this guy comes in screaming at him going, get off of that chair. This is Abraham Lincoln's chair.
What?
This is What a Joke.
With Tom Papa and Fortune Feimster.
Comedy Bang Bang.
Yeah.
600
episodes?
600 episodes, 10 years. Yeah.
Crazy.
So it's a, I started a podcast when no one knew what they were.
I was about
and,
to say, how did you know that this would be such a thing?
It, you know what? I sort of just lucked into it and then I started reading articles about, you know, podcasts and how they were going to explode in a few years and started a company and, you know, I don't know. It's
Earwolf.
Crazy. Earwolf, yeah. So, and I think we have like 80 podcasts now or something.
There's, God.
Yeah,
really?
It's crazy. Yeah.
What's the biggest one on the network?
I think How Did This Get Made with Jason Mantzoukas and Paul Scheer is really big. And
huge.
I think Conan's podcast is really big as
well. Conan's on there too?
Yeah, yeah.
Man, people fell in love with that quickly. People
well, he started podcasting, as Variety said.
Oh, that's right.
Conan is really big now, yeah.
Yeah.
So I think those, I don't pay attention anymore because I'm not in charge anymore. So,
oh, you're not?
No.
You gave it up?
I stepped down. I gave it up.
Sold that company.
That's smart.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So what's next? What's the next big
thing?
You always know what's coming.
The next big thing.
Are
I think
the next big
thing? There's got to be something better than comedy at a certain point, doesn't there?
If we're asking, are we the next big thing, we're not the next
not
big
happening.
Thing.
How long we're a hit show.
How long have you been doing this?
Since July.
Yeah,
oh, cool.
On.
Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah, we're a hit show.
I was so excited to see your names on the thing when I was told I was coming in here. Yeah. I was like, okay.
Yeah, friendly
people. Not the usual strangers.
Yeah, exactly.
We get to talk about comedy all the time,
which is fun. Oh, boy.
Do you have a thing in your head? Like maybe it is the next step isn't comedy? Maybe there's something else out there?
If something makes me laugh, I really, really enjoy it. Like Detroiters, the TV show, or like John Mulaney special. But I also tend to not ever watch comedy, so I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, it's true.
It's just there's got to be something funnier. Wasn't there?
I hear Marc Maron has a podcast. Is that true?
I'm not sure about that. I have no interest, so I've never investigated.
Joe Rogan? I don't know.
Yeah, Rogan?
Yeah.
I don't know. I've never heard of that guy either.
Yeah, not sure.
People love him.
But you guys are sticking to radio.
Yeah, we're sticking with radio. We think radio, we're waiting for radio to come back around.
We have podcasts, but I don't have 300,000 a week listening to it.
You don't?
It's purely just I got in early. And I think like people subscribed and just automatically listen now or something like that. You know, it's not a sign of quality necessarily.
No, it's Scott again. All right.
Yeah, back with his bullshit for another day.
So, Between Two Ferns.
Between Two of the Ferns.
I'm so excited.
The movie. Really? Thank you.
Yes, because I loved the
web show.
From Funny or Die.
Yeah.
Whose idea was it? It wasn't Zach's. It was yours, right?
No, it was the two of us. We, like 11 years ago, I think at this point, I was doing a TV show, and I wanted him to do something on it. And he couldn't be in the cast because even then he was like kind of too big of a name. Even this is pre-Hangover. So he was like, I'm not going to agree to be in the cast, but I'll do one video for you.
Right.
So we got together and we were sort of talking about what we would do. And he said, you know, I've always wanted to do a talk show, like a fake public access show. And I just have a title, Between Two Ferns. And it made me laugh because I had had a public access show and Zach had a public access show when we were just starting out.
Oh,
I had one in high school.
You did?
Yeah. And
what was that?
It was with my high school. It was called Centurion Highlights because we were the Cypress Centurions.
Right.
And it was like a news show about, you know, what was going on at the high school, which I quickly just turned into a comedy show of me doing like Letterman-esque bits, you know,
in
the
80s. That's hilarious.
So I knew that when you did public access, you at most would have, you'd have a black curtain and you'd have two chairs and then two really big plants to fill up the entire frame to make it not look just like an empty wasteland.
Yeah.
So the title made me really laugh. So we just, I'd been talking to Michael Cera about doing something on the show. So we said, oh, let's do it together. And we improvised it in like a tiny basement and then put it together, and the show never went forward, so I put it on Funny or Die, and just kind of exploded.
Oh my God.
Just from that one, and we thought that was going to be the only one that we were going to do.
Right.
And then Jimmy Kimmel called and said, hey, do you want to do another one with me? And we're like, no, we did it already. What are you talking about?
Why would we do the same thing?
Yeah.
But so we did that one, and then we were friends with John Hamm, and he started doing Mad Men, and we were like, okay, we'll do one with John because we're friends.
Yeah.
And then we're like, that's it. And then suddenly Natalie Portman called, none of us knew her, and we were like, she wanted to do it, and we were like, I think this might be an actual thing that we could do.
That's so crazy.
Yeah, it just got crazy. And then Zach did The Hangover, and he got super famous, and it was like, oh, okay, then it just got nuts.
Then it was, then you have Obama there.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
It's so crazy.
Yeah, it's so crazy to work with the president of the United States.
I know.
Was it Justin Bieber he spanked?
Yeah, he whipped him with a belt.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh my God, they're so funny.
What was it like when the president came in? Was it lockdown? Was it?
It was weird because Zach and I thought it was not happening.
Right.
So weirdly enough, I had a lot of preconditions about it. You know, normally you think like, oh, whatever you say, I'll just do anything to get this video made.
Yeah.
But I didn't want it to be lame, you know. Uh-huh. So I said, okay, if we can do it like a normal episode, we'll do it. And to their credit, they were like, okay, yeah, no problem.
Wow.
And so but still the whole time we were like, this is not happening. And we're going to get word that he's canceled it. We're sitting in the White House map room, which is where they planned World War I. And so they have all these maps with like yarn and push pins where the routes where all the troops were, you know?
Holy cow.
And we're just sitting there and Zach like sits down on a chair and this guy comes in screaming at him going, get off of that chair. This is Abraham Lincoln's chair.
What?
Oh my God.
And we're like, well, put other chairs in here.
Yeah, or like a rope around
it. Yeah, but those were the only chairs were these antique chairs. So then we're just talking for another 20 minutes, and suddenly the guy bursts in, and we realize we sat down on the chairs again, and he's like livid.
You're like, my dog's barking.
You know what's crazy about that is I had no idea you did it there.
We did it at the White House.
I pictured it out here.
We intentionally put a thing where the curtain falls down so we could show it was at the White House, but it could have been a set or whatever.
So
we were just the whole time going, Zach and I kept looking at each other going, you realize this is not happening.
Yeah, but then
suddenly he strides in the room and he says, two ferns! And he like claps his hands and we're like, this guy gets it. And we found out later he had no idea what the show was. He thought it was called Two Ferns. And that's why he said, we thought he was just shortening it because he's the cool president.
Cool president,
He's like, two ferns, wow.
Two ferns, listen to it all the time.
So, it was very, very intimidating.
I love show business stories, success stories that are like the reluctant, like, we're not really going to make these. And it's like, it becomes bigger than you even. You're like, we're not going to push it, but it just slowly starts happening.
Well, the other part of it was I was doing my own TV show, Comedy Bang Bang, and I was in the middle of production when they called and said, hey, we think the president is going to do this. And I had a really busy week where I had a bunch of guests that I couldn't reschedule. And so I said to the White House, I was like, I could maybe get Monday off. Do you think he could do it on Monday? And they were like, yeah, okay, we'll do it on Monday. It just was like they were kowtowed. I don't think they knew that they could impose like restrictions because they didn't ask us to edit it differently or anything like how we're used to with all the Hollywood stars. They're nothing but restrictions. You know?
Like, I have a hard out.
Yeah, exactly.
How did it become a full movie? Like,
So we've been talking about doing something because we made a Comedy Central special a few years back. But a couple of years ago, I just finally figured out how to do it. I kind of just wrote down the story really quick and pitched it to Netflix. And they just said, yeah, okay, great. And so it's an improvised movie. We wrote barely a script. We just kind of wrote scenes and we shot it like an actual documentary where we didn't have a beginning or a middle or an end. We just shot a bunch of stuff.
Right.
And so it's an improvised movie like Spinal Tap or Waiting for Guffman.
Oh, that's great.
Well, yeah.
Was the editing a nightmare?
Yeah. So that was, so when you decide to do that with a movie, it gets very difficult.
How much did you shoot?
We shot like a 5-6 hour movie. There's this part in the movie where Zach works at a public access station and you see a promo with all the other shows that are on the public access station.
Yeah.
And it's like Phil Hendry has a show and Matt Besser is talking about sports. And we shot like full episodes with them. Literally you hear them for 3 seconds each.
Oh my God.
So we shot like full episodes with every celebrity who's in it, and we couldn't fit full episodes in the movie, obviously, but we're going to put those out later.
Oh, that's smart.
But yeah, I mean, we shot a huge movie that we had to whittle down to 82 minutes. But
that's great. Yeah. Are you happy with it?
Yeah, I'm very happy. I've shown it maybe 10 times to different audiences trying to fit, you know, get the best version.
Right.
And the last version that we finally put together, people like went apeshit for. So.
Oh, that's great.
So
excited.
Oh, man.
Well, Scott, you're the best.
Thanks, Scotty.
Thank you. For-